Man versus monkey seduction pattern. Way back in the day, we humans didn't have a lot of extra thinking time. For example, we were hungry and we had to spend a lot of time getting food. Sometimes days of thinking and planning and scheming. This type of thinking is not like anything most people have experienced today. This was very much a daily failure is not an option situation. You and a bunch of dudes must find something big to kill. If you don't, everybody dies. If you do, everybody parties like crazy. A very big positive if you succeed. A very big negative if you lose. These are the conditions under which our brains, our imaginations, and our thinking powers were calibrated to get the things we needed so we wouldn't die. Those that did this best got the best rewards, sex, and the propagation of these genes. Those that didn't do this good enough didn't propagate those genes. Today, life is much easier, at least with respect to getting enough food to not die and not worrying too much about getting eaten. But we still have the same instincts. That's why 2/3 of people are overweight. Food is easy. Way back in the day, food was difficult. So those who could get food got sex. The alpha killers. Today, food is as easy as calling up DoorDash. Only you don't get the reward of sex by ordering yourself a burrito. All you get is the burrito. Nobody is going to treat you like a rock star because you successfully convinced a stranger to deliver you a burrito. Our instincts for both sex and food had to be as strong as possible. Because getting food and the resultant sex, if you were good enough, was scary. Today, everything is mixed up. It's not hard to see that all of our problems today are a result of ancient instincts in the modern world. But lucky for us, we still have our powerful brains, and we can still strategize. Just like we can use our conscious brain to overrule our instincts to eat healthy and exercise. We can use our conscious brains to come up with a much better strategy to become attractive to others. Back in the day, it was easy. Kill a big animal and Bob's your uncle. Today, it's not so intuitive. But neither is riding a bicycle that doesn't go anywhere, or lifting a heavy weight over and over again. Similarly, there are plenty of non-intuitive ways to create massive attraction. They don't really make any more sense than riding a bike that doesn't go anywhere, but they work just as well. To learn how, visit mindpersuasion.com/first-impressions.